The COVID-19 pandemic has brought our world to a standstill, raising scary questions like, how is the virus spreading? Is it mutating? If so, what does that mean?
Mutations in itself is pretty mundane because viruses continuously do this, bacteria do this. You know, all organisms mutate, but the vast majority of the time that these mutations really do nothing to impact the virus, nor should they be a concern to the public.
That's Dr. Nathan Grubaugh. He's an assistant professor of epidemiology at the Yale School of Public Health, and his lab studies something called genomic epidemiology.
We sequence viruses to understand their genetic code and their genetic relatedness. And based on that genetic relatedness, like how you would construct a family tree, we make these phylogenetic trees. And that helps us to understand how outbreaks in different regions are actually connected.
His methods have been applied to other viral epidemics like Zika and Ebola, so he's familiar with studying how viruses spread and mutate.
We like to say that we embrace mutations versus fear them, because the collection of them end up becoming this very powerful tool for us that reveals a lot of hidden information. So that is what my lab is doing now, is we're sequencing viruses from Connecticut and collaborating with people from around the world to construct these very large phylogenetic trees so that we can see the true patterns of spread. We can investigate if the viruses that are causing outbreaks in Connecticut and other regions, if these are being caused by domestic importations or if they're being caused by international importations. So we have a study right now that's on MedArchive and is in review that has done just that. And we found that the outbreak in Connecticut is actually phylogenetically linked to the outbreak in Washington State. So the virus has already been spread coast to coast in our country. And by looking at travel patterns and epidemiological patterns, we also see that there's a higher likelihood now of viruses being introduced into our region from other U.S. states than internationally. So that should impact how we do policy.
Dr. Grubaugh's findings have been aided by open source data with his colleagues from across the field.
Especially in genomics, we're really good at sharing data and creating these websites where we can aggregate a lot of data together to learn more as a community than we can as just one individual working in this silo. And also because we need to do things quick, we have these portable technologies called a MinION that we can actually generate data really rapidly. Things like this just give us so much power to control the amount of data and the speed of data that we can generate and how we disseminate that.
While the cases continue to grow, so does the amount of data at the disposal of the medical community.
I don't study coronaviruses or respiratory diseases, but our group does have a really good handle on virus evolution and genomics and all the technology that goes in with it. Here at Yale, we're working with the hospital and such a wide net of collaborators so that we can do more to help our local community. And I think that gives us a leg up on being able to respond to this as it grows and intensifies, because we're learning so much about what is happening right now as a collective team.